I move $105,041.
Second.
Okay. The first question was, do we have hard 2015 rates for electric, heating, fuel, and water, or are these just estimates? They're just estimates. I believe that Mr. DeRoches had done, the Board of Selectmen, I think, had some questions in regards to the electric accounts in the budgets and some of the increases in spending on those line items, and he had done a presentation for them, and I think in the end his belief was that what we had budgeted for our electric accounts was accurate with what he was seeing as use, and he sent me some spreadsheets today that I was hoping I would be able to. I kind of wanted a summary so that I could read some words for you guys, but instead I got these spreadsheets that don't mean a whole lot to me when I looked at them quickly. So I will go back to him. I don't know if Jim has any insight. I remember he came and talked to you guys briefly one night at a Board of Selectmen's meeting.
I remember talking. I remember him being, hoping that by knowing the usage and stuff, but not knowing what's going to happen with the utility rates, that they could go up 40%.
Mm. When will we know this, though? I mean, I've been getting notifications in the mail from water rates are going up, and electric rates are going up, and my gas is going up, and they've given me by how much. So I got to believe this is November, but by the time we have to decide on this budget, we should know the rates.
I see.
Well, and the electric is a problem because we have various costs, our contracts in play there.
Yeah.
And so that would have to probably come out of Dick DeRoche's
energy committee.
The water, you're probably right, you know.
And the gas, natural gas.
It's a stunning thing. I mean, the United States is becoming an energy exporter, and yet our energy costs are going up in New England. It's stunning. You would think the state legislature would do something about getting more gas pipelines up here.
This is all energy related. We don't have...
I'm not an expert, unfortunately. Right. Like I said, I was hoping I'd get a nice little summary to present to you, but I have Excel spreadsheets and I wasn't able to make an educated discussion.
I'm going to suggest, rather than expand on the discussion on this, we table it until we have something that has some teeth in it to make
And I believe he may have given Fred, that Dick might have given Fred, a presentation of some sort, but I didn't have access to that, so... Okay. I can also look into trying to see if I can get whatever documents were given to Fred, or if the Board of Selectmen got a summary.
I second your table.
I'm not making the motion.
I'll second it.
Well, why don't you make the motion, then he can second it.
I'll move what Eileen said.
I'll second it.
To table it.
That's a good idea, because Unitil, as we speak, is having a meeting right now projecting rates, so it's good to table it, because we'll have more information after tonight.
We need hard dollars.
One thing I just want to add to that, also fuel rates. I know we buy, the state buys in bulk, and I don't know what their schedule is for what they buy, because this isn't only going to affect this line here. It's going to affect the big three coming before us. I don't know what the schedule is, but the price per barrel is down.
Gasoline, you're talking about.
Yeah.
So $77 a barrel.
Fuel oil. So
it used to be 105.
So we may see an increase in electric, but a decrease in fuel oil. So
you need to know that.
I don't think we can make any decisions based on what we don't know right now.
Right.
All right. All those in favor of tabling it?
Right.
Unanimous. Thank you. I'm sorry.